All right, we've got your ticket to the universe with a Greenville resident who's a NASA scientist. This morning, we welcome Kim Arcand to the show. Good morning. Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Look, I may have been called a geek. I love this stuff.
I love geeks.
That's okay. So see, we got something already.
We do.
We have something in common. All right, your new book right here in front of us looks like a great book. Tell everybody about it.
Sure. Well, my co-author and I, Megan Watsky, wanted to write a book about astronomy that was fun and entertaining, something accessible you could sort of, you know, sink your teeth into. It's for the curious, the explorers at heart, no previous experience required. The idea is to, you know, kind of show that the sky belongs to everyone. You don't need a doctorate in medicine to know when you're sick, and you don't need a literature doctorate to appreciate a good book. The same way you don't need an astronomy degree to sort of sink your teeth into something like this.
This sounds like a great book to have as someone who's interested in astronomy, or just for a family who may be going out at nighttime.
Yes.
And you're out there with the kids at nighttime, you're looking up at the stars and wondering what's going on up there.
Yes.
And you can take this book out and refer to it.
Exactly, yeah. I do a lot of stargazing with my kids. You can do it driving down the road and looking up and try to find the Big Dipper. We actually have in Greenville a public library that lets you borrow telescopes with your library card, so you can host a stargazing party with your friends.
That's great. So you have made astronomy not boring. You've made it fun.
Hope so.
Well, I hope so. I'm sure you have.
I hope so.
How did you get involved first in astronomy and then not only astronomy, but you made a giant leap for mankind and went to NASA.
Yeah, well, so my undergraduate work was at URI, and it was in parasitology, but
all
I
right,
knew...
Wait, back up.
Okay, I used to study super tiny things.
Thanks.
Fleas, ticks.
Got it.
And the sorts of diseases that they can give you.
Okay.
So things like Lyme disease, which is very prevalent in Rhode Island. But I realized I didn't want to do that forever. I didn't want to be that when I grew up, and I actually came across a job for NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory. And it's just an amazing telescope. It goes about a third of the way to the moon, and it looks at things that are superheated, like exploding stars and black holes. And I've been there ever since, about 15 years.
So for you as a NASA scientist, what is it like to look through that telescope and see something out in the middle of nowhere, I guess?
It's amazing. And those are the sorts of images that are in the book. You know, we've tried to curate a really cool, fun collection of some of the best sights to see. And the resolution, the data of these instruments that we have available to us, it's amazing. You know, the universe is literally yours to discover, so.
And you also have this book here that you're doing. Lots of things going on down at URI with all of this astronomy, right?
Yeah, well, so I worked at URI for a little bit. I've actually been doing some work at Brown University. I'm just, you know, sort of spreading all over the place. But the headquarters for my specific observatory is in Cambridge, too, so it's a wild ride.
A lot of long nights? Are you up late at night looking at the stars?
No, actually, I'm kind of a bit of a wimp.
Are you really? What kind of astronomer is this?
A lazy astronomer. I like my desktop astronomy. Unfortunately, I'm usually sleeping by like 9:30. So,
all right.
But you can still get some good stargazing in before 9:30.
Good stuff. All right, where can we get the book?
It's on Amazon.com. It'll be in Barnes & Noble starting April 2nd, and it's in a bunch of independent bookstores as well. So
very good. Well, thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks
it's,
for having
it's
me.
Great to have you here.
Yeah.
Great book to pick up family for the kids and everybody at home. Your ticket to the universe. We'll be sure to post more details on the Rhode Show webpage at WPRI.com.